Hi Scorpio, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to your in-depth love read. Let's see Scorpio, how you're feeling now, how your person is feeling and what action we can expect in this connection. And these are general collective readings, Scorpio, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind, take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Scorpio and send them the messages they need to hear the most for their love life now. Thank you. All right, Scorpio, let's start your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you. Thank you for being here. And Scorpio, if you're new here, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. So, Scorpio, newbies, I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side will be for you, one side will be for your person. And in the center, I'm going to have your mutual energies, your dialogue message cards, action cards, etc. All right, so okay, let's take, if this is your reading, Scorpio, you'll know which side you're on, right? This is person A for me, this is person B for me. Bottom of my deck, I have an Empress in reverse. Why are the Empresses, the collective Empresses, feeling rejected or feeling unloved? I don't know, because I just finished doing the Pisces reading and this was the overall energy for that as well. So Scorpio, from what I'm seeing here, Scorpio, somebody wants to have forward movement. They do want to communicate, they want all that, but maybe they don't want a long-term partnership, or they don't see, they are not ready for commitment. The other person, is a bit confused, like I was for a second. The other person is a bit confused. They feel, my person is not reciprocating. They are not showing me any love. Am I just an option to them? What is this connection? Of course, I'll clarify all these cards, Scorpio, don't worry. I'm going to start with some dialogue message cards and let's see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be, and then we'll clarify these, okay? So Scorpio and their person spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Scorpio and their person, if they could say something to each other, what would that be? Scorpio and that person. All right, I'm going to take a few more Scorpio from another deck. And if any of you are looking for personal readings, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Scorpio and that person. Okay. All right, good to go, Scorpio. Let's start your reading. The first card here says, I'm sorry for the mind games I played. I know it was wrong. I did see that. I'll come to that later, I'll tell you. When I see this card, it's all about mind games and, you know, trying to be the one who wins, and we'll come to that. Anyway, so somebody's sorry for the mind games they played. They know now it was wrong. I'm embarrassed over how desperate I became and what I did. Do you still respect me? I'm having a hard time believing that you really love me. I think person B is saying that. I just saw the confusion on their end and saying, like, you are not showing me anything. I'm feeling unloved. I'm having a hard time believing that you really love me. No one comes close to all the good things that you've done for me. It's hard because we can't seem to work out our differences. And the last card here, Scorpio, says, just know that I'm sorry. Second card saying the same thing. Sorry for the mind games. Just know that I'm sorry. Okay, so let's see why all that was happening. I'm going to start with an angel blessing card, Scorpio. Let's see first what my angels have for you as a blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. Steady progress. I think that is what is required. Maybe that's going to start now. Maybe it started off in a very weird way, and one person could have wanted to have control and maybe have played mind games even though they saw the potential, and things went awry, right? But I think what the spirit is saying, take it slow, take it steady, and there is potential here. So somebody does need to take steady progress in this connection for it to work. All right, so person A. Now, I don't know which side you're on, Scorpio. I'm not judging. I'm just reading energies. So person A, person B. I'm going to start with person A. This could be you, that could be you, only you know. So person A, Eight of Wands. What's the Eight of Wands? Yes, person A feels, I want a new beginning with person B. I want to have forward movement with them. I want to communicate with them, but I'm not really ready for a commitment, right? They want to still maintain their freedom maybe, or not get tied down, because both these cards are saying the same thing, Ten of Pentacles and the Four of Wands in reverse, but wanting this brand new beginning. They do want movement with person B without maybe attachment or expectations. Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Why do you feel this way? Ten of Pentacles in the reverse. They're realizing that their person has walked away from them, and this person could have been a bit of a player, I don't know. They know they need to decide. They are recognizing why their person is now no longer showing interest or maybe walking away. Somewhere in their mind, they've made up this story, I think, that, you know, oh, my person has walked away because I'm not ready for commitment, or I don't want to commit, or they're feeling heartbroken big time. They don't want to be a player. They're very heartbroken. Maybe this person was in the past. They wanted that freedom. They wanted to be, have that communication and yet be, have their, you know, free time or have other relationships. But now I think person A does want to drop this juggling act that they've been doing. They don't want to be a player. They're feeling very heartbroken because now they recognize that person B is their sunshine. It is person B who makes them really, really happy, but they may have already damaged the connection for a little bit because of their behavior of saying, hey, you know, I'm just a player and I don't believe in commitment or something like that. So what happened in the recent past, person A? What happened here? Why are you feeling, oops, everything is over, I've killed it, I've damaged it? So what happened in the recent past? I could be wrong, but I think person A fell in love. Ace of Cups. Yeah, they fell in love. They saw person B and they thought that this was perfect partner. This was a perfect partner for the long haul, right? This is the person I can fall in love with. This is the person I should have by my side. But maybe they thought that person B would not love them back. Maybe person B had no love to offer them, or was not showing them love, or what happened? What happened, person A? What happened? Yeah, person A thought that person B just wanted a friendship. It was a good friendship, but that there was no offer of love. So they may have become a bit defensive. Because of that, things may have come to a bit of a stagnancy. Person A, in that fear that they would not get reciprocated, I think started playing mind games. I'm better than you, or you're not good enough, and I'm free and I want to have third parties, or whatever this person could have. This was out of fear of feeling that they were not lovable, or they would not get the reciprocation of love, because they fell so hard. They fell in love with person B instantly, I think. But that fear that it would not get returned back to them, they started behaving in the Five of Swords energy, which is playing mind games. And now this person is saying, I'm sorry for the mind games I played. I know it was wrong. Yes, now they're scared they will not get a second chance. They feel I did something wrong here, I shouldn't have done that. Now they know they have to start from scratch, steady progress. They know they'll really have to put in the work now to get it back on track after the way they've behaved. So how do you feel about the connection now, person A? Person A says, I want to prove to person B that I'm an emperor. I want to be that person that who is not into third parties. Maybe this person was disillusioned in the past. Maybe this person was disillusioned in love in the past. They were in a bit of depression. They didn't believe in commitment. But I have a feeling this person is now wanting to level up and be seen as somebody mature, somebody who's leveled up, who can be that emperor, who wants to now take forward action in their life. But the problem here, Scorpio, is that they see that person probably has their guard up now, has their boundaries up, no longer that cup of love being offered, but maybe just straightforward communication. Queen of Swords? Yes. They feel that they've exhausted this Queen of Cups now. This Queen of Cups is no longer fighting for this connection. They feel that this Queen of Swords probably sees them as a heartbreaker or a playboy, somebody who's very self-centered, very selfish, and they don't like that. They actually want to be seen as an emperor now. Okay, so what action person A will take to prove themselves, I will open later, Scorpio. Let's go on to the other side and see what's happening here. So person B, why is the Seven of Cups here? Seven of Cups in your fields. Why do you feel the Seven of Cups? Okay, so person B says, I'm so confused. My person A was lying to me all this time. I don't understand their communication. It was very foggy. I didn't understand what they were saying. Maybe person B feels that I caught them lying or I caught them doing something they shouldn't. Maybe person B feels person A had wanted lots of options, which is correct, because person A was doing that, right? They were trying to show that illusion, like, hey, I'm not in love with you, you know. I don't believe in love. I don't believe in commitment. And now person B is in the Queen of Cups energy in reverse. They feel all right. So then if that's the way they want to play it, then I'm not going to be part of the competition. I'm getting myself out of the competition. If they want to have options, I'm not going to be one of them. I call ending. I have no love to give to a person who's not going to reciprocate to me. And me alone, because this person is the Empress. The Empress, whether upright or in reverse, is somebody of very high standing. They know that they command everything good. They don't suffer fools very easily. So person B, what happened in the recent past that you are now feeling this way? Person B says that initially I thought we could have a great partnership. There was equal give and take. You know, we could start off something which would, you know, make us both very happy. The Nine of Cups was there. The Six of Pentacles was there. It started off pretty well. I thought, you know, this is going to make my wishes come true, because they came across as charming, fresh, romantic, good looking. They did and said all the right things, but there has to be a but here, Spirit. What happened? Knight of Cups? Well, this person switched up. From being the Knight of Cups, they turned into somebody very immature and rash with their behavior, not showing that they were stable maybe, or not offering anything stable, and it could have, well, it didn't go very well from what I can see. Like, you expect somebody to come with a cup of love and they turn out to be very, very, how should I say it now without being rude? Somebody who is just creating conflict for without reason, when there is no reason for a fight, right? Or any unhappiness, somebody just creating it. They were playing mind games, person B. They just said that. They didn't show that they were interested in anything stable. That's what person B is saying. So how do you feel about the connection now, person B? Person B says, I'm taking a chill pill at the moment. I've retreated. I've surrendered to the universe. If it's meant to be, it's meant to be. This person was very immature. They were a little petty. They were emotionally younger than me. And it's no skin off my back because I know my worth. I'm still single and I'm attractive and I'm making good money and I know I can attract attention and I'm very, very chilled out and satisfied in my own space. So I'm going to allow the universe to take the wheel for a little while I take a little rest. Okay, so I'm just going to surrender and see what happens in divine timing. If it's meant to be, it will be. If not, big deal. So, Wheel of Fortune, yes, person B is saying, I will not allow them to play mind games with me anymore. If they think they can play mind games with me and get away with it, well, I'm going to stop it. I'm going to stop it because my life is moving around just fine with or without them. I know I can get whoever I want. I have a lot of options in front of me as well. Look at all my options here, Omkara Tarot. Right? So actually the decision is in my hands. I'm not going to wait around for somebody who's going to play mind games with me. I'm the Empress. I decide who I want in my world, who I don't. So I think person B is taking a chill pill here and surrendered to the universe. If it's not meant to be, it's all right. Next, please. Okay. So what actions will you guys take towards each other? Let's check that now. Scorpio, I'm going to take a separate deck for this one. And this is my time to remind you to click that thumbs up button. Even if it's just entertainment for you or it's resonating, it just helps the videos to circulate and reach a wider audience, Scorpio. And yes, it does make me very happy to know how many I'm resonating with. And newbies, when you do subscribe, don't forget to hit that notification bell so that YouTube can then notify you when new videos are released. All right, so person A, action from your end. Five of Wands. Why is the Five of Wands here? Person A as action, too many cards, one by one please. Why is the Five of Wands an action? Too many cards again, just one by one please. They're all over the place. 1 minute, I'm gonna go slow. Okay, be patient with you, person A. What is the action you intend to take towards person B or towards this connection? Why is the Five of Wands here? Oh, the Emperor again. The Emperor showed up again. They want to fight for this connection and show person B, you know what? I am an Emperor. Don't disregard me. I'm coming to fight for this connection. I see. Oh my God. They are so stuck on person B. They have fallen in love and they envision a 10 of cups with person B. Right? So yes, they are willing to fight for this connection and show person B that I am your emperor. I'm not a player. I'm not a playboy. I'm not, you know, a knight of cups or of wands or whatever. I was just hiding it because, well, I thought maybe you would chase me or... Okay, so person B, what's going to be your action? Seven of Swords in reverse. Why is that an action? Why is that an action, person B? Why is that an action? Seven of Swords in reverse. Too many cards. Seven of Swords in reverse. Why is that an action from your side, person B? Okay, that was a good one. I don't know what that is. We'll flip it. Let's take a couple more, Scorpio. Okay, and one more. Okay, All right, so the action person B intends to take is person B feels somewhere that they're in a very good place at the moment. They're in a very good place. They don't want any cheaters, liars in their life. They feel I've already caught person A in a lie already. Do I really want to give them a second chance? Person B seems to be in the Empress mode, right? Let me take one more. Is it with person A or otherwise? What is the action you want to take towards person A? If any. Action towards person A. Person A knows what they want, big time. Oh my God, look at the cards this person is getting. I don't know which side you're on, Scorpio. They have the Four of Wands, which is, this is what they want. They're looking for a brand new stable offer, which is going to take them straight towards stability, happiness. The sun is here, the star is here. They're not settling. They're not settling for anything less than the best. This person is really ascended. This is the Empress. So I think what person B is saying, I've already caught them in a lie in the past. They never made me that offer. Well, I would like to end the conflict with them. And if they come to me correct this time, maybe we can have a brand new chapter together. Or, you know what, Omkara Taro, I'm already the star of my own life. I'm in a very good place and I'm not going to settle. I'm not going to settle for some half-baked offer. I'm not going to sit around and wait for somebody to reject me or they, you know, feel lonely, bored. This person knows their worth big time. Can I take one more? Person B, you're really impressing me, but I still need to know, these actions are towards person A, or are you going forward, maybe closing up with person A and starting something new somewhere else? Six of Pentacles. Person A just, I don't think, is writing person A off. They're just saying, well, I need them to show me. I don't want somebody to hide their feelings or play mind games. I'm looking for nothing but the best. I want an equal give and take. I'm ready to love. I want somebody to show me love. I'm ready for everything good in my life. Everything good in my life. And yes, they are not settling for people who are going to just keep them hanging or lie to them. So yes, steady progress, Emperor, come on, you have to do something. I'm going to take one more for this Emperor. Emperor, are you going to do something? Make any moves? So now we have an Emperor to the Empress. At least that's what this person wants to showcase. Oh yes, they see that the Emperor sees potential in person B. This is the person you are for the long haul, Omkara Taro. You think I'm going to let this one go? No, I'm going to show them. I'm going to put in steady progress from now on. Okay, so yes, excellent reading for you guys, Scorpio. Steady progress is required. Start from scratch. Person B is an Empress already. Person A has been hiding the Emperor side of them. But it can work out with steady progress. Okay, that's all I have for you, Scorpio. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.